सवा सौ करोड़ देशवासियों को नमन करता हूं, सलाम करता हूं। कोई चार घंटे लाइन में खड़ा रहा, कोई छह घंटे खड़ा रहा, लेकिन तकलीफ झेली। आपको भी पता है कि अचानक आठ तारीख को रात को आठ बजे पांच सौ और हजार की नोट्स। मुसीबत सवा सौ करोड़ को हो रही है, लेकिन फिर भी सवा सौ करोड़ को लगता है कि अगर इतना सा झेलने के बाद, अब आपने देखा होगा, अब तो व्हाट्सएप पर सब आता होगा, पहले गंगा में कोई चवन्नी नहीं डालता था, पहले गंगा में कोई चवन्नी नहीं डालता था, नोटे बह रही है गंगा जी, नोटे बह रही है। मैं इस बात को स्पष्ट मानता हूं, बिना हिसाब का अगर कुछ आया हाथ तो उसका देश आजाद हुआ तब से आज तक का हिसाब चेक करने वाला हूं। ईमानदार लोगों की रक्षा करने के लिए मेरी सरकार सब कुछ करेगी, और बेईमानों को तो हिसाब चुकता होके ही रहेगा। कुछ स्थान पर तो लोग पांच पांच घंटे खड़े थे और अचानक एटीएम काम करना बंद कर, तो भी चलो कल ठीक हो जाएगा, ये अपने आप में देश के उज्जवल भविष्य की निशानी है, उज्जवल भविष्य की निशानी है। हिंदुस्तान का सामान्य मानवी भी अगर उसे अवसर मिले, मौका मिले, जिम्मेवारी की बात आ जाए, जैसा आपने करके दिखाया, वह भी पीछे रहने वालों में से नहीं है, ये मैं अनुभव से कहता हूं। हमने पहले एक स्कीम ली कि भाई आप इतना दंड देकर के जितना दे सकते हो दे दीजिए, तो करीब 67,000 करोड़ रुपया है। तब भी कुछ लोग तो कहते थे कि मोदी फेल हो गए, मोदी का कुछ नहीं हुआ, लेकिन आखिर भी आंकड़ा आया तो अब वो बोलते ही नहीं। और पिछले दो साल में इस प्रकार के अलग अलग जो प्रयास किए, करीब करीब 1.25 लाख करोड़ रुपया वापस आया, 1.25 लाख करोड़ रुपया। जब लोगों को पता चला कि इसी गृहिणी के कि हर महिला सब्जी लेने जाती है, थोड़ा बचा लेती है, साड़ी के पल्लू में बांध के रखती है, घर में सब खाली हुआ, मुसीबत आई, वो निकाल के दे देगी, लो जाओ जाओ ले जाओ। हमारे देश में महिला कुछ न कुछ बचा के रखती है, और ईमानदारी का होता है, कोई बेईमानी का पैसा नहीं होता है। जब हमने कह दिया कि अगर किसी गृहिणी का 2.5 लाख रुपया अगर वो बैंक में जमा कर देगी तो सरकार उसको नहीं पूछेगी कि 2.5 लाख रुपये कहां से आए थे,
right? Meanwhile, the opposition is using the common man to attack the government over the demonetization drive. In fact, they're imputing political motives to the drive against black money. Have a look at this. We're coming back for our debate.
Na media walon ko samajh mein aayegi, na aapke crorepati malikon ko samajh aayegi, na pradhanmantri ji ko samajh aayegi. Yahan pe logon ko kashth ho raha hai, dukh ho raha hai, dard ho raha hai, isliye main inke saath yahan khada hu.
After Rahul Gandhi's ATM photo op, it was Kejriwal and Mamta's turn to target the center. क्लेमिंग कॉन्स्पिरेसी बिहाइंड द डीमोनेटाइजेशन ड्राइव।
8 नवंबर को जब प्रधानमंत्री जी ने ऐलान किया था कि 500 और 1000 रुपए के नोट बंद किए जा रहे हैं, उसके पहले इन्होंने अपने सारे दोस्तों को, जिनके पास असल में इस देश का सारा काला धन है, उनको और भाजपा के लोगों को पहले से सतर्क कर दिया था।
लेट अस ऑल द ऑपोजिशन पार्टी वर्क टुगेदर फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ द कंट्री, टू सेव द डिजास्टर फ्रॉम द कंट्री, टू सेव द डिजास्टर फ्रॉम द इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन।
सम इवन डिमांडेड अ जुडिशियल प्रोब।
এবং এই ইনভেস্টিগেশন আমি মনে করি সুপ্রিম কোর্টের 5 জন অ্যাক্টিং চিফ জাস্টিসকে দিয়ে করা উচিত। এই কদিনে দেশের কত টাকা লোকসান হয়েছে।
ব্যাংকো মে কতার হে, আম আদমি লাচার হে, আর মোদি জিম্মেদার।
উইথ অপোজিশন রিফিউজিং টু রিলেন্ট, দি ফিনান্স মিনিস্টার ইস্যুড আ ওয়ার্নিং টু দোজ ট্রাইং টু ইউজ দ্য সিচুয়েশন টু দেয়ার পার্সোনাল বেনিফিট।
ইস পরিস্থিতি কা কোই লোগ गैर जिम्मेवाराना अफवाह फैलाकर, जैसे कल नमक के संबंध में हुई, पर्याप्त मात्रा में सब राज्यों में है। एक बात स्पष्ट है कि इस योजना का पूरा जो उद्देश्य है वो क्लीन ट्रांजैक्शंस हैं, क्लीन मनी।
एज पीपल कंटिन्यू टू लाइन अप फॉर इंटीग्रिटी, द नेताज रिमेन डिवाइडेड ऑन ब्लैक मनी क्रैकडाउन। द बिग क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट विल इट टेक फॉर द पॉलिटिशियंस टू पुट इंडिया फर्स्ट।
Prime Minister Narendra Modi said today that earlier people didn't even put a coin in the Ganga. Now there are 1,500 rupee notes floating on the river. Meanwhile, the opposition says that the common man is hurting and the big fish will get away. What is the truth? What is the spin? We have with us Syed Zafar Islam, national spokesperson of the BJP. He's joining us from Delhi. Ami Yagnik, spokesperson of the Congress, joining us from Ahmedabad. Saugata Roy, Lok Sabha MP of the Trinamool Congress, he's joining us from Kolkata. Sudhendra Bhadauria is leader of the BJP, he's in Delhi. Bijon Mishra, consumer activist, also live from Delhi. And Mohandas Pai, chairman Manipal Global Education Services, is also with us. Let's begin with Sudhendra Bhadauria from the BSP. The finance minister, Mr. Bhadauria, Arun Jaitley has said today the opposition is coming out with irresponsible political reactions. Mayawati, your party leader, has been very angry. Amit Shah is also saying that why is it that the BSP, Congress, SP and Aam Aadmi Party are particularly upset over demonetization? He wants people to question these four parties. What do you want to say about that, Mr. Bhadauria?
Well, there are two things to this. Number one, the kind of harassment and pain it has caused to the people of this country is well known, that there have been deaths of children, women and senior citizens. And for even in the state capital of Delhi, where when they go to the hospitals,
no,
they are not willing
you're
to take money.
You're taking the cover of the common
so
man.
This is one aspect.
You're taking of the cover.
The other issue is...
Yeah. But why...
No, let me...
Why is the, BSP
me,
so upset about the demonetization drive?
The BJP... I am telling you, the BSP is a party belonging to the marginal sections of Indian society. It is our duty to raise the issues and grievances of the people, and if we fail in our duty, then we are being irresponsible.
That is why
we want to say that the Prime
all
Minister
right, okay,
and Bharatiya
okay.
Janata
You're
Party
taking the support of the common man.
To divert the attention of the people.
Yeah.
Because they did not fulfill the promises to the farmers, to the unemployed youth. They did not get the black money back, putting 15 lakh rupees into the accounts of each citizen. Having failed on all that, now they are coming with these. This will be like an emergency. Mrs. Gandhi started the Nasbandi. This Notbandi will be also like the decimation of Mrs. Gandhi. They will also feel...
Ami Yagnik from the Congress Party. Ami Yagnik from the Congress Party. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, in fact, today quoted your party leader, Kapil Sibal, who has said, the account is mine, the money is mine, then why should I stand in a line? My question to you is that, why can't you set politics aside for the larger national interest, Ami Yagnik?
See, there is no argument on politics here. You can see the plight of the people. It's a fact that each one has his own money which is earned and put in the bank account. And to get that money out of that account, you have a cap on that and you have to stand in long queues. What is wrong if somebody mentioned that?
But why do you make it? We are all going to be inconvenienced for a few days, but the national benefits are huge. But the national benefits are going to be huge. Why can't we stand in line for a few days? So what? One second. Ami Yagnik, the inconvenience is for a few days. The national benefits are huge. Why can't we stand in line for a little bit? Looking at the national benefits.
No, you listen. The question here is not standing in a queue.
Kapil Sibal is saying that.
How well and how poorly it is managed. You are going to ask 3 weeks to see that the ATMs start working. So you have not put the preparations in place. You have not planned it properly. I do not understand. There is reason to believe there are some reasons why they had to make an announcement at 8 o'clock, give a time limit only up to 10. They had to make an announcement at 8 o'clock, give a time limit only up to 12. What are you trying to do?
Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has made it clear today. They couldn't have done it earlier or warned the banks earlier because had there been a leak, the big fish, the big black money holders would have changed their money.
It's a shame.
That's why. And listen, Ami Yagnik, Ami Sai. See, we people are all ready to stand in long queues.
Ami Yagnik. You know the people who are holding. You do not want to come out with a list.
We are ready to stand in big queues at railway stations and at toll plazas. Ami Yagnik. We are ready to stand in big queues in railway stations and toll plazas. Once or twice, why can't we stand in big queues in front of banks to clean up our system?
Queue is just one factor.
Yeah.
Queue is just one factor.
You all are talking about the queues.
Queue is just one factor. It reflects on the government's arrangement that it is very, very poorly done.
Syed Zafar Islam from the BJP. What do you want to respond? What do you want to say to Ami Yagnik? Mr. Islam from the BJP.
Let her finish. Then I'll
respond. She's finished. Go ahead quickly. We don't have so much time.
Of a party which actually famously known. No, I'm saying that she is a spokesperson of a party which is famously known as the party of a scam and scamsters. So obviously she will question why the timing of 8:30 or 8 p.m. because she knows that their corrupt leaders didn't get time to do anything to maneuver. So it is obvious that she will, the party which is known to be corrupt, their leaders are corrupt, are the ones who are actually making so much noise.
That you have already leaked this information.
Mrs. Yagnik, let me just complete. I very patiently listened to you. Common man on the street is hailing Alka. Mrs. Yagnik, let me complete. Then I let you complete. Then I am speaking. I am saying you don't talk about common man. Common man, yes, they are going through pain, but they feel that their contribution to the government and to the vision of Honorable Prime Minister to eradicate the corrupt from the society and flush out the black money. Let me equate this entire process. It's like it can be best equated with the labor pain women go through. But once she has gone through the process, then everybody in the family is happy, and it actually the common man can be equated or seen as one who is going through the pain, and I'm sure that everybody will be happy after the process. And the common man, if you ask on the street, he will hail this move.
Mr. Bhadauria, Mr. Sudhendra Bhadauria from the BSP, very quickly, the BJP president Amit Shah said,
they will not say nice things because they are the ones who have actually flooded their economy.
In fact, Mr. Bhadauria from the BJP, one second, Mr. Islam, we have many more guests. We're going to quickly rotate around our guests. One second. I'm going to come back to Mr. Islam. One second.
All right.
All right. Okay. One second. Mr. Bhadauria from the BSP, BJP President Amit Shah said, BSP. One second, Mr. Engel, that we have three other guests. We have to rotate around over here. Mr. Bhadauria, Amit Shah says that why is it that the Congress, your party, the BSP, the Samajwadi Party and the Aam Aadmi Party are particularly upset? I mean, he's basically saying that if you people are clean, why are you getting so upset about the whole thing, Mr. Bhadauria? Is the BSP clean on black money, Mr. Bhadauria?
You see, well, let me say this. That as I had said it earlier, and let me reiterate this, it is the responsibility, the prime responsibility of a democratic party to air the grievances of the people. And we have rightly done so. And as far as Mr. Amit Shah's statement is concerned, he can answer why 10, 11, 12
Amit Shah's casting an aspersion on your party and the other three parties.
And they have not been raided.
Saying, why are you so scared and angry if you got nothing to hide?
What is the reason? Because there is a, they are hand in glove with these people.
Very, very happy because you people who have actually plundered your leader is Mayawati, is known for what?
By, like a rock with Bahujan Samaj Party in Uttar Pradesh.
And don't you know that? Tell me every person who be asked, who is the leader, and who is the leader?
One second, you're not answering my question, Mr. Bhadauria. My question was that Amit Shah is basically trying to... One second, Mr. Islam. Mr. Bhadauria, Amit Shah was basically trying to imply that some of your... Mr. Bhadauria, look at the importance of what Amit Shah was saying. Mr. Bhadauria, Amit Shah was trying to cast basically an aspersion that the political parties that have lots of black money are the ones who are angry and upset. You're taking the support and the cover of the common man. But the parties with lots of black money are upset. That is the import of what Mr. Amit Shah was saying when he referred to your party and the other three parties, Mr. Bhadauria.
Why should they not rate them? Why should they not rate them? Are they hand in glove with those people? That means that the BJP government is hand in glove with those people who are hoarding black money. They are not able to act against them. They are only acting against the farmers and the marginal people and all those people.
Amit Shah is basically trying to imply that all the parties that have lots of black money are getting very upset.
It is a
Mr. Islam, one second, calm down. Mr. Islam from the BJP. Mr. Islam from the BJP.
Mr. Islam from the BJP.
None of you are answering this question, Mr. Islam from the BJP. There is a common perception that most political parties have a lot of black money. Now, Mr. Islam, the murmurs are before the UP election, you've outwitted a lot of your opponents.
And BJP tops.
What do you want to say about this?
The BJP tops that list.
Yeah.
The BJP tops that list, Mr. Vidal, please point it out.
Let him answer,
our government is... Can you just make me speak, please?
Let me
answer, then you speak.
Have you outwitted your opponents in UP before the election?
Unfortunate that these political parties are speaking
about it.
Let me answer, Mr. Bhadauria. Have some civility, please. Have some civility. You are a very seasoned person.
Mr. Bhadauria, follow you speak at the same time. We can't hear any of you.
Party which has some civility.
No, but tell me something. You answer on behalf of them.
Mr. Bhadauria.
Mr. Islam, answer the question.
Let me speak. At least let me respond.
Have you also outwitted your opponents in UP?
So what I'm telling you that this... No, that's not the intent. See, that is absolutely untrue. From the day when we formed the government two and a half years ago, first December we took SIT.
Mr. Shagotarai wants to say something.
Second...
Quickly, Mr. Islam, I'm going to go to Mr. Shagotarai after this.
No, I'm saying that, see, all the dissent we've taken, like amendment in Benami transaction, Benami bill, amendment in the double taxation avoidance treaty with the safe havens like Cyprus and Mauritius. So then IDS, then so many things we have done. We have come out with a bill and law to for people to declare their foreign assets and the foreign income. So we have come up.
So you're saying this is part of the ongoing drive. All right. Got the point. Let's move quickly forward to Mr. Shagota Roy from the Trinamool Congress. Yeah, Mr. Shagota Roy. Mamata Banerjee is also very upset and angry. She's called it a big black scandal. She says the markets are ruined, purchasing power has been crushed. My question to you is that why can't we all put up with a little less purchasing power for some time for the bigger national benefits because of this demonetization drive, Mr. Roy?
No, I want to ask you, yeah. Are you a spokesman for Mr. Narendra Modi? You are not taking into account the sufferings of the common man, not only those who stand in line, those who
suffering
do not have
of the common man.
Money.
The only problem, Mr. Roy, is that Mr. Badoria and everybody else, the opposition parties, are using the poor man to oppose the demonetization. Mr. Shagota Roy, let me ask you a counter question. Who is going to lose the maximum tax money?
What is your question?
The poor man or the rich man, yes. Mr. Shagota Roy? Who's going to lose the black money most? Poor man or the rich man?
Doesn't matter. In the name
now it doesn't
of
matter.
Robbing the...
Oy. Who's going to lose the black money most? Poor man or the rich man?
Doesn't matter. In the name
now it doesn't
of
matter.
Robbing the... rich people have black money.
No.
The poor people
all of you are using the common man. All of you are using the common man as a cover.
The government
who's
has
losing
no
the big black money?
It's a whimsical
the poor man or the rich man?
By Narendra Modi.
Please answer that question.
He wanted to do this, show it before the election.
One second, Mr. Sahib.
The poor people are suffering.
No.
They don't get.
One second, Mr. Sahib. Mr. Shagota Roy was asking, why am I being a spokesperson for Mr. Modi? Let me ask him a question.
Why?
You are being a spokesperson of the poor man, Mr. Shagota Roy. Mr. Shagota Roy, let me ask you a question. You are trying to be a spokesperson for the poor man.
Yes, yes.
Who is losing the maximum black money because of demonetization? The poor man or the rich man? Yeah. Why are you taking the cover of the poor man?
I do not know.
Who's losing the big black money?
Let the government say.
The poor man or the rich man?
Let the government say.
Answer the question.
Let the government say how many
answer the question.
Have been affected. The poor people are being put to enormous hardships, and the whole financial situation is in jeopardy. The security of people is being threatened. It's a financial emergency. Modi is Muhammad bin Tughlaq. He is the great gambler. Before UP election, when his surgical strike failed, he has done this thing, but without any preparation, he has put the people to enormous difficulties, without taking into account the hardship that will be caused to the people.
Mr. Shagota Roy, let me give you some figures over here. Mr. Shagota Roy, give me 15 seconds. Let me put some figures in front of you and ask you to comment on these figures. One second, Mr. Shagota Roy. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said today, and I'm sure you've heard that, Mr. Shagota Roy. One second, Mr. Shagota Roy. Let me put some figures to you. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said today that in the first 2 days of demonetization till 12:15 p.m. this afternoon, in other words, in the 2.25 days since the announcement, people have deposited 47,868 crore into the State Bank of India. Now, the State Bank of India is the largest bank in the country. It has 20 to 25% market share. Yeah, so he says that if you multiply that 47,000 times 4 or 5, the figure is 2 lakh crore approximately. Look how much money is going back, how much cash is going back into the banking sector. And this is just in the first 2.25 days. Do you not see the huge change in the economy, the huge national benefits of all this black money, of all this cash going back into the legitimate system, Mr. Shagota Roy?
Mr.
Shagota Roy.
Economic benefit of this?
One second, Mr. Shagota
Roy. Yeah, you got your point. Out of this exercise?
Mr. Shagota Roy? Well, one second, Mr. Badoria, why don't you answer the question? 2 lakh crore has gone into the banking sector in cash in 2.25 days. Why can't you see the bigger national interest in this?
We have seen this 2,000 rupee note will create double black money in days to come. And I can tell you that they are buying gold from this black money. They will buy more real estate and more gold and more diamond. 2,000 rupee notes are being printed. And now, earlier with 500 rupee notes and 1,000 rupees, so they'll double the black money in days to come, and you will see. And
all right, Mr. Bhadauria, a lot of people have been asking this question. Let me put this to Mr. Islam of the BJP. Let me put this to Mr. Islam of the BJP.
Mr. Islam will not be able to perform and will not be able to finally become a jumla.
Yeah, Mr.
They will
Islam.
Say, like in the past, they have said it was a jumla, and finally they will end up with a jumla.
Let him just stop.
Mr. Islam, 2,000 rupee notes have been printed. How are you going to prevent the new currency from becoming black again then?
See, Jujar, you must understand the intent of the government. Intent of the government is not to make common man suffer. Intent of the government is only, we understand the common man is going through some pain, but we also understand that we will hunt the tax, those who are evading tax, those tax defaulters, or those who are actually into black marketing, and those who are actually into corrupt practices in the society. So we will hunt them. But a common man, they must, this spokesperson of the various political parties, must understand the economic benefits of this exercise, because it will have many, many advantages. First, if whatever money which actually doesn't come, with the black money which doesn't come back to the banking system, will actually, to that extent, the government liability will get reduced. And to that extent, the money, and whatever money will come into the system, will actually help eventually to reduce the banking system. It will strengthen the bank, and it will eventually reduce the interest rate in the system, and it will benefit
Let's talk about the inconvenience to the common man.
It will have huge
Bijon Mishra. Bijon Mishra there.
I'm telling you that during UPA and in Congress Raj, people used to stand in the queue for kerosene oil. People used to stand in the queue for ages. For a gas connection, it is a matter of only few days. Everything will get stabilized and people will be extremely happy. But those who are actually Ami Yagnik from the Congress party.
All right, Mr. Sam.
Mr. Bhadauria knows that his leader actually is known for selling tickets through and accepting black money. That's why he is making this kind of statement.
Ami Yagnik from the Congress party. There is lots of inconvenience to the general public.
Biggest corrupt Bharatiya Janata Party represents the interest of the big corporates who have made cornered the maximum benefit from this country.
And we represent this kind of down-corporate, the marginal, the valid, and the poor of this country.
So talk about yourself. The way you have cheated and misled this country this time around, you will be shown the door. You will be made to fight. Both of you talk of each other, we can't hear anything. Even Congress, she is selling tickets for money.
You have absolutely no right to talk about it. If both of you talk of each other, we can't hear any of you.
All right. Ami Yagnik from the Congress party. People are facing a lot of inconvenience. One second.
You don't have to tell anything. People will ask you. We'll catch you in UP when you go. You will not be able to face the crowd.
All right. Ami Yagnik from the Congress. It is true that a lot of people are facing a lot of inconvenience at banks today.
You need to worry
the finance minister saying that it takes 2 to 3 weeks to recalibrate all the 2 lakh ATM machines around the country.
You are exposed to yourself.
Also, Mr. Islam, you know, I mean,
we are not worried.
A few people can't monopolize the debate.
Completely exposed for misleading the people. Mr. Islam is completely exposed for misleading the people.
All right. Let's go to Ami Yagnik. Ami Yagnik, we know there's lots of inconvenience to people. The FM is saying it'll take 2 to 3 weeks to recalibrate all the ATMs in the country. We also know that the cost of printing all these new notes might be somewhere in the region of 20,000 crore rupees. My question to you is that, is all this though worth it in the larger national interest of getting black money converted to white money, of creating a deterrence for people who've been dealing in black money till now?
See, Jujar, if this is going to be the result in the end, and as the finance minister said that, well, it will take 3 weeks to sort out the ATM machines, and then in the long term, all the black money would be converted to white, it would have been very good and a gesture on his part if he had given the list of hoarders he has and the Swiss list which he has of the people who have stashed their money in the last 2 years to the country. Instead of taking out the money from these poor people, labor class people and farmers, and he should have given this list to the people of the country that now we will be, after these holders, we will...
All right. Lost the link to Ami Yagnik over there. Shugota Roy, the basic question, which is, I think, what the PM and the FM and everybody from the BJP, I mean, their main argument is this. We know the common man is facing hardship, but the hardship is going to be for 2 or 3 weeks. Is that worth it or not worth it in the larger national interest? Shugota Roy.
It is not worth it in the larger national interest. In the 69-year-old history of our independent India, nobody has tried such a desperate gamble, putting so many lakhs and crores of people to difficulty. There is no guarantee that this will bring out all the black money, because the government at the center had earlier failed to bring back black money from abroad and put it 15 lakhs in the account of every man. It has failed to stop Benami transaction in spite of passing a bill. It had an amnesty scheme and it failed to raise more than 60,000 crores out of the amnesty scheme. I am sure that this ploy of theirs will also fail, because it is clear that the government did this without much thought and without much planning. The ATMs are not ready even to handle the 2,000 rupee notes. The banks are not able to meet the rush of customers. And this basically goes against our constitutional right that I deposit my own hard-earned money after giving income tax in the bank, but I am prevented from raising more than 20,000 rupees from the bank. This is utter nonsense. This is an attack on the fundamental right of common people. And now the Prime Minister is threatening us from Japan that
Mr. Roy, it is unfortunate that you come from a political party who is known to be extremely corrupt, and there are lot of times you have been exposed, or your party
Mr. Islam, BJP in West Bengal kept 3 crores in the week before this disclosure. You know, just before Narendra Modi made this announcement, West Bengal BJP deposited 1 crore with Indian Overseas Bank. The news was leaked to select persons in the BJP. It's a well-planned conspiracy in which leakage has taken place all over. BJP units all over the country have been depositing their money just before this. This is the allegation. And now Narendra Modi is threatening us from Japan.
You're making an allegation against the BJP. Let the BJP spokesperson quickly respond to you on that. Quickly, yes. Mr. Islam. Then we're going to move forward.
Let the BJP also tell us how many deaths have taken place in this recent 4 days since Mr. Modi announced this. Let them tell the nation how people have died, how children have died, how women have suffered. Let them give information to this country.
If at all we had to do it, we could have done in many other places. But, no. But you know that. That is, whatever you are telling has absolutely no merit. The Honorable Prime Minister has given us, had kept it very secret, and there was a surprise element, and you people are the victim of the surprise element because you didn't get time to maneuver at all. And that's why you are accusing, alleging BJP, because BJP, in the eyes of a common man, is the one who has taken
the time to maneuver.
No, you've
got the time to maneuver. And
only
you very
those
happy about
who are
it.
Talking
so
against the national interest, will
please
speak against about it. Otherwise, every single citizen who respects,
two, 3 months,
the national interest as paramount will never even
One second, Mr. Islam.
Kind of statement you are making.
You know,
because
all
Mr.
the
Bhadauria,
parties
I really fail to understand why you are speaking about common man.
That you have lots
don't
of black money,
you
got time to maneuver, you did not get time to maneuver.
Don't you know that?
Why not? Because we represent the common man, you represent the monopoly houses.
But Mr. Bhadauria, let me just ask you,
you
know, a lot of the common man that we've all spoken to, Mr. Bhadauria, why are you assuming that all the common man is very upset with this? Mr. Bhadauria. In fact, the majority of the common men and women that I've spoken to in the last 3 days are not upset with this drive, by the way.
Please come with me. I invite you, Mr. Jujhar. I extend my invitation to you. Please come with me tomorrow morning, 6 o'clock. I'm leaving in the morning and I will show you how common man is suffering in Uttar Pradesh. Come with me to Itawa district and you will see thousands and thousands of people complaining. And then you come and tell the BJP spokesperson,
the reality of the common man is suffering.
Fertilizer. Yeah. The farmers can't do anything. The sowing season is there.
Don't talk about
they
farmers.
Have
what
do
you have done for farmers?
To the market to sell their wheat, rice. Nobody
one
is there to buy.
One day you say that farmers
so
are not taking
it.
They are dying.
They
second day you say that farmers
put so much of inconvenience.
One second, Mr. Sir, both of you talk over each other. We can't hear any of you. Please understand that. Mr. Islam, if you talk over each other, we can't hear any of you. I mean, please understand that. You're defeating yourself. Nobody's hearing your argument. Yeah, Mr. Bhadauria, you're taking the cover of the common man, but I'm sorry to say that I've spoken to several common people, that there are some of them upset, but the majority, you know, just before entering the studio for this debate, Mr. Bhadauria, just entering the studio for the debate, 10 minutes before, you know, I spoke to the wardrobe boy, you know, in our office over here and asked him, he's a poor person, and he said that he is inconvenienced, but he said, I wish this had happened earlier. It's a good thing.
Also over here.
Even Mr. Bhadauria, I spoke to the guard man outside our home as well. He's a poor man as well. He also said he's just opened a bank account so that he can put in some of the cash which he has accumulated, which is more than 4,000 rupees over time.
Uttar Pradesh, please come and with me. I invite you, Mr. Jujhar. Please, Jujhar, I invite you. Please come with me. You are my guest. Please come to my village and I will show you the situation.
Ami Yagnik from the Congress Party. Ami Yagnik, are you there? I can't see Ami Yagnik. Ami Yagnik, are you there?
People are suffering because of you. They will not complain about us. It is the Gunda Raj. Because of that, people are suffering in Uttar Pradesh and maybe in your village too. And you have not done anything for them. Today you are making noise.
People are suffering because of
today you are making noise. Even though the common man is happy. Don't even talk about common man because common man is extremely happy.
Please don't talk over each other.
Have you ever seen common man is standing
in front of you? You're constantly talking over the other guy. He can't either you or the other guy.
You want to muzzle the
voice. Mr. Bhadauria, please.
Therefore, people will show you the door.
Mr. Sugata Roy, in the first 2.25...
No, don't keep on speaking. He keeps on ranting. You tell me.
The common man why does he keep on ranting?
Why are both of you talking over each other? We can't hear any of you. I don't know why that point is not getting across.
He's talking all utter nonsense and you want me to accept it? It is all lies.
We're not hearing any of you because you're talking over each other.
Trying to put across. We will not accept this, that he will mislead the people of this country.
I'm not talking.
Mr. Sugata Roy, in the first 2.25 days since the demonetization announcement, 2 lakh crore approximately has already been deposited with our banks. A huge amount of black money is becoming white. The banking system is going to have more money to lend to people and companies. Tax revenue is going to go up. More people are opening bank accounts. More people are getting deterred from evading tax in future. A major part of our economy is getting cleaned up. Why can't we appreciate the bigger benefits out of all this instead of just cringing that, oh, for a few days, for 2 or 3 weeks, we're getting very inconvenienced about the whole thing? Mr. Sugata Roy.
No. You haven't studied the economic implications of this. You read Prabhat Patnaik's article today, or you read the article by Swaminathan Iyer. They have explained how this ultimately, this step will not help in unearthing black money. Because black money is invested mainly in gold. They have explained how this ultimately, this step will not help in unearthing black money. Because black money is invested mainly in gold, jewelry, diamonds, real estate, land. So, the cash is only the tip of the iceberg, the rest is below. This is a dangerous gamble. It's not only inconvenienced people, it has jeopardized the whole economic system.
Yeah, I think you made a good point over there.
Cash,
let me put that to Mr. Islam
the
from the
major
BJP.
Media
Mr. Islam, Mr. Islam, please answer Mr. Sugata Roy. Black money is kept in cash, but it's also invested in jewelry, properties, foreign bank accounts. Now the demonetization is dealing with the cash bit. What about the gold? What about the diamonds? What about the properties? What about the foreign bank accounts where people park their black money, Mr. Islam?
Mr. Jujar, let me give you 2 specific responses. One,
they have totally failed to get black money from abroad.
How it will benefit, in fact, it will... Let me just complete. Now you have asked the question, let me... That how it will benefit, that I told you, how that interest rate will come, how the advantages of that. Secondly, the money which will not come in the system, to that extent, the liability of the government of India will come off. And the fiscal deficit what we have, which to that extent it will get bridged. If suppose 5 lakh, so just for the example, 5 lakh crore doesn't come into the system, and the scammers do not bring it to the banking system, then to that extent, 5 lakh crore will, to that extent, liability will come off. Government need not raise that amount, and the fiscal deficit will completely bridge. So it will. That is the advantage the economy and the country will have. The rating will improve. The cost of doing business will improve. Ease of doing business will improve. That tax net
right.
will improve.
Let me just get a view on this, Mr. Islam, from
yes.
Mr. Mohan
Das
Pai.
Short term, I'm telling you.
Final question, Mr. Mohan Das Pai.
There will be some pain. There will be some slowdown in short term, but in long term, it will only benefit, and the GDP growth will grow. It will have a better GDP growth, the economic activity will grow, and it will only have positive advantages on
all
the
right.
economy.
Mr. Mohan Das Pai, how much will the current demonetization drive?
You have somebody
reboot the economy,
sector,
considering that a major amount of black money is kept in jewelry, property, and foreign bank accounts, Mr. Mohan Das Pai.
See, people have invested black money in jewelry. You saw reports that gold has gone to 50,000 rupees. And all the jewelry shops, the day Prime Minister Modi announced, till the next day, they were all making bills, fake bills. I think if you find people putting 500,000 rupee notes into the bank, which is much higher than what they have done in the past 1 week, each day, or past 1 month, then I think flag should be raised and their money should be seized and they should be penalized. It's very clear the vulnerable sections like consumer durables of high value, like gold and diamonds and jewelry, high price furniture, etc. I think there's a lot of black money washing that's happening all across the country. And I hear that even in cooperative banks in Maharashtra, where they had a cash, I'm told by some people that they took the cash in the night and washed the cash and took away all the 50, 500 rupee notes. They've gone to many, many temples, and with the connivance of the management, they've given 500,000 rupee notes and taken away all the temple hundis.
Right.
I also heard that in many, many temples, they've given a lot of this money with the promise that in the next 1 week, 10 days, whatever money they give, less 20-25%, they'll get back 50-100 rupees notes from all others who come and put the small change over the next 1 week, 10 days. So
right.
I think the temples,
anyway,
many of the temples...
Mr. Mohan Daspai, we completely run out of time over here.
Laundries,
the completely run out of time over here. But
laundries,
let's just say this, looking at some of the figures over here,
outside
India, by the way, has only 35 million taxpayers, out of which only 3.8 million people in this country are 1.25 billion. Imagine, out of 1.25 billion Indians, only 3.8 million declare income of 5 lakh and above per year. Obviously, there is a big reason to clean up the system and get most of India, which is either avoiding tax or evading tax, to start paying their fair share of taxes. We leave it over there. The debate will carry on in the meantime. Thank you very much to all our guests for joining.